सब्सक्राइब कीजिए नेहरा क्लासेस यूट्यूब चैनल को और बेल आइकॉन को दबाइए हमारे लेटेस्ट वीडियोस के नोटिफिकेशंस पाने के लिए।
हाय गाइस, हाउ आर यू? होप यू आर डूइंग वेल। वंस अगेन वेलकम टू अवर नेहरा क्लासेस यूट्यूब चैनल एंड आई एम योर फ्रेंड विकास नेहरा दिस साइड। फ्रेंड्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज बेस्ड ऑन द कॉमेंट्स विच आई हैव रिसीव्ड फ्रॉम यू गाइज। Many people were asking me to upload a video on how to configure SSH alerts on email in Red Hat Enterprise Linux 7 or 8. So in today's session, I will tell you how can we set the alerts for SSH in our machine. So for that, you have to log in the machine as the root user and you have to ensure that the local YAML repository is properly configured in your server. If you don't know how to configure it or you face any challenges while configuring local YAML repository, you can watch the video. I will provide you the link in the description and in the I button as well. Now, our first step is to install few packages which are required to configure these alerts. So you have to install mailx and sendmail in your server. You might have either one or both the packages pre-installed, so don't worry. You have to ensure that both these packages exist in your machine. After that, what you need to do, you need to start the service of sendmail. So let's start sendmail service, systemctl start sendmail, and enable it as well so that the service get started its own if you reboot the machine. So we will enable this also. Now we need to go to the root home directory, that is slash root, and you have to list the contents of this directory. Here you will see a file that is bashrc file. It is a hidden file, so you have to longlist the contents including the hidden files with option hyphen al. So you need to open this file in vi editor and you have to come at the last line of this file and paste this line which I will provide you in the link in the description of the video. You have to paste this line here. This line is used to configure the alerts. So here what it does, it generates an alert with the subject as root access. You have to specify the IP address or hostname of your machine here. You have to provide your own IP address here. After that, date, who, mail hyphen s, and at the last you have to provide the email address on which you want to get these alerts. Be ensure that you use Yahoo mail account because only Yahoo is supporting these alerts, because I have tried on Gmail and other email service providers as well. Sometimes those don't accept these kind of alerts. So it is better that you use Yahoo. If you don't have a Yahoo account, you can create it. Or if you are working in an organization, you can provide your own organization's IP address. This is for the private machine, which I'm going to show you. Now save this. So we are done, we are ready to test it. Now try to do SSH into your machine. So I'm going to do SSH localhost and you have to specify the password of the root. Now go to the inbox and see whether we are receiving the alerts or not. Check in the spam folder as well. So let me refresh my account. It can take few seconds. So we have received the alert. You can see that we have tried to log in at 4:43 local time. So we got the alert at 4:43 and alert is root cell access, showing us the IP address of my machine. on the root account and all these details. We can verify the same with tail verlog mail log command, in which we can see the last 10 lines of the log file. Here the mail is showing as sent successfully. So in this way we can configure the root alerts for the root login. Now what happens if you want to configure the alerts for some other user as well? So you have to follow the same procedure: login in the server with root account, install the required packages, and then go to the home directory of that particular user for which you want to generate the alerts. So I'm going to show you that. For example, I am using the username as vikasnehra. I am going to configure the alerts for this user. So open the bashrc profile file of this user. Same, go at the last line of the file and paste this line. Here you can replace it with the name of the user, then the root. Instead of root, you can write the username. Now save this file and test it. So I'm going to do SSH from the other terminal this time. So let me open a separate window. 192.168.1.107, and this time I am going to log in as vikasnehra. So now we have to specify the IP address, sorry, the password of the user. We have successfully logged in the machine. Now let's test whether we are receiving the alerts for this or not. So wait for some time. Yes, you can see that we have received the alert for vikasnehra user as well. So in this way we can configure the SSH alerts. It is very easy method. Keep in mind that you use only those email addresses who provide this service, because due to TSL and encryption issue, Gmail is not supporting it. So either you can use your own organization's email address, because in organization you will be able to send these emails, or if it is a private machine, private server, then you can create the account on Yahoo Mail, which is currently supporting this service. So friends, I hope from today's session you would have understood how can you generate the alerts for SSH login, and I hope you would have enjoyed the video. If you like it, then do share it with your friends. And if you are new on our channel, then do not forget to press the bell icon after subscribing it. Keep sharing our videos and keep liking them. Thank you so very much. I'll see you guys in any other session. Till then, bye bye. Jai Hind. Vande Mataram.